Here's the good news, though, for you fans of the warmer temperatures. We're going to continue to see that warmer air press into our direction. High pressure is making its way off the coast now, and you have a clockwise flow of air around the high, so we can clearly see that warmer air mass to our south and west. And with more of a southwesterly wind flow now taking shape, that's going to bring back those warmer temperatures. Folks starting to get their travels underway here this Friday morning, and yes, it is pretty comfortable. You can see kind of a bowing effect here, if you will, and a tight gradient between nothing and quite a bit more in the way of intense activity with this line. That's usually a good indicator of some very strong winds. So we have this strong cold front moving in. You have strong upper level winds aloft as well, what we call wind shear. So it's a good combination for severe weather. And as I said, we'll have to watch and see just how much daytime heating we can get to build up that instability in the atmosphere. If there's more in the way of clouds that hang around throughout the day, well, then that could definitely help to cut down a little bit on the storm coverage and the severe intensity. Continue to deal with some of this icing, and it can be very deceptive because you think a lot of times when it's raining, oh, temperatures would be above freezing, wet roadways, no big deal. But that's not the case with the setup that we have here. With freezing rain or freezing drizzle, essentially what you have going on, most of the air above the surface is above freezing for the temperatures. So you get that precipitation to fall from the clouds. It's just in the liquid form. But what happens is cold air is right at the ground. Temperatures right at the ground are below freezing. Warm air is less dense than cold air, so it wants to sit naturally above that cold air. So right at the ground, you have temperatures that are below freezing. So it's rain for the most part, but when it hits the ground, it freezes on contact. And that's how you get that little glaze of ice, and it doesn't take much to create problems. We've seen the accidents this morning, folks. We're talking less than a tenth of an inch of total ice accumulation, but still obviously enough to make for those issues. So take it very easy out there. Really the best thing to do in some cases is just stay home this morning if you can absolutely do that. We can see the cold air wedged in place down the eastern seaboard this morning up against the Blue Ridge and the Allegheny Mountains. It's a setup that we call cold air damming. Now, a lot of times if you have a northeast wind locked in place, that'll hold this cold air. But what's happening today is we have winds turning more out of the south and southwest, and you can see that warmer air to our south and west. That's eventually going to erode this cold air. So later this afternoon, we do anticipate temperatures to be well above freezing, maybe even close to 50 degrees. I think it's the morning, a good chunk of our morning, where we stay below freezing. We deal with some of that icing, but probably by the noon hour, certainly there past, we're seeing these temperatures climb. So a chance for some plain old rain showers, although it may just be a spotty shower or two, could actually see some breaks in the clouds later this afternoon. Then for tonight, temperatures steady, if not rising, so no icing issues here. Just an isolated shower chance. It will be a little breezy, and those breezes stay with us tomorrow. But check this out, we're talking temperatures up to around 60, certainly east of the Blue Ridge, and that will be in the morning, I think, as a cold front tracks in. Rain will be likely for a good chunk of our day. There could be some downpours with that rain, but then the cold front will move away, and we'll see some clearing sky later with falling temperatures. So the first storm system this morning moving mainly off to our north. You can see the steadier, heavier, wintry weather there. We're tracking a second piece of energy across the southwest that'll roll northeastward, and it's this piece of energy that moves through tomorrow, that cold front I mentioned, that brings that steadier rain in. And look at all this cold air coming in behind it. That'll set the stage for some chilly conditions again to start next week. So here's how things pan out with our futurecast model this morning, dealing with some of that ice, and then as said, this afternoon could actually see a little bit of clearing sky, just an isolated shower chance. Mostly cloudy for tonight, mainly dry conditions, a spot shower. Here we are at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning, steadier rains queuing back up to our west with this cold front. That moves in after 7, 8 a.m. We'll deal with that through the afternoon hours. You can see maybe some of the downpours, but by 6, 7 o'clock, looks like that's exiting to our east, and sky's clearing back out then for our Sunday night and on into our Monday. So your Michael and Son 7-day forecast. At least we're seeing a warming trend through the weekend, folks, to help melt away that ice. Again, 60s possible tomorrow, breezy conditions, but we're back to 37 on Monday, sun and clouds, a high of only 40, partly sunny Tuesday, more seasonable sunshine Wednesday, some showers and milder temperatures coming Thursday and Thursday night before another cold front moves through to drop things back to seasonable levels for next Friday. Fair skies. We'll send it back to Sean now.
All right.
We do have a severe thunderstorm warning in effect for a very small thunderstorm cell currently tracking very quickly off to the northeast across southeastern portions of Nelson County. It's moving off to the northeast at about 50 miles per hour. This is a severe thunderstorm warning up for southeastern Nelson County and southwestern Albemarle County. That includes Lovingston, Schuyler, over towards Scottsville. This goes until 5:15 p.m. this evening. We'll put a storm track on this, and if you're in the McAuliffe area, Porters, Blenheim, between now and 5:17, it is very well possible this storm could track through your area. Wind gusts to 60 miles per hour, one of the biggest concerns thunderstorms right now, and also torrential rain that could lead to flash flooding. Of course, you think back to last night, we had a lot of that flooding in southwestern Alamaro County, so we'll really have to pay close attention to that. There is another storm that's strong, but no severe warning at the moment for it, moving near the James River out of Buckingham County into Fluvanna County now. So Palmyra, Wilmington, Ferncliff, Mineral between now and 5:30. This storm cell could move through with at least wind gusts to 40 miles per hour and maybe some pea-sized hail, but be on alert for possible strengthening of that cell and any possible warnings that may be issued. There's another line that we're tracking, showers, maybe a rumble of thunder back across the valley moving eastward. At the moment, though, this is just your general garden variety, but of course the atmosphere remains conducive for severe storms. Severe thunderstorm watch up for the entire viewing area until 10 o'clock tonight. Any flash flood warning in effect, a flash flood watch, I should say, in effect here for the county shaded in green until 8 p.m. this evening. I'll continue to keep you posted on the latest, and check out Twitter, Facebook, and NBC29.com for all the latest updates as well.